Good morning. I am Ashutosh Gupta. Course code CS451. Course title Compiler Design. Today the topic is Syntax Directed Translation. Introduction. What is Syntax Directed Translation? What is the need of Syntax Directed Translation? In this lecture, we will discuss about the attributes that are associated with the terminals and the non-terminals. What is syntax tree, parse tree, annotated parse tree? What are the synthesized attributes, inherited attributes, and what is dependency graph? What is DAG, directed acyclic graph? So we will discuss about these topics in this chapter. First, see what is the need of syntax directed translation. We have the context free grammar. For the representation of the context free grammar, we have for a context free grammar to represent certain property as uniqueness in the type declaration or type completivity in the performing arithmetic operations, define the region of the variables, type casting, type conversion that are used in the program, that are being used in the program. So hence semantic analysis is done to handle issues that are beyond the syntactic definitions. You know that we have a input string, that in the lexical analysis the input string is converted into the tokens, then in the syntax analysis these tokens are arranged in some hierarchical structure. That hierarchical structure is called syntax tree. So after the syntax tree, now we will apply here in the semantic analysis we will discuss how attributes are associated with the terminals and the non-terminals. In SDD we will also learn the static analysis. So according to this, syntax directed definition is a kind of abstract specification. So we have the input string, the lexical analysis convert the input string into the tokens, then from the tokens the syntax analysis it build the syntax tree. So this is the syntax tree. This syntax tree is generated. Now the tree is traversed for evaluating the semantic rule for the parse tree. So in a single parse implementation, semantic rules can be evaluated during parsing without explicit construction a parse tree or dependency graph. In such semantic evaluation at the node of the syntax tree, the value of the attribute is defined for a given input string. Such a parse tree containing the value of the attributes at each node is called the annotated or decorated the parse tree. We will discuss in detail about the annotated parse tree, syntax tree or parse tree. So see, the SDD is a generalization of a context free grammar in which each grammar symbol has a associated set of attributes partitioned into subsets called the synthesized and inherited attributes of the grammar symbol. An attribute can represent anything we choose, a string, a number, a type or a memory location. Again, we have a parse tree. A parse tree shows the value of attributes at each node. It's called the annotated parse tree. The process of computing the value of attributes at the node is called annotate or decorating the parse tree. See the definition of syntax directed definition. Syntax directed definition is generalization of the context free grammar in which each grammar production X in alpha is associated with the set of semantic rules of the form A equal to F B1 B2 up to Bk, where A is the attribute obtained from the function F. Here F is the function, A is the attribute. So the attributes can be a string, a number, a type, or a memory location, or anything else. So there are two types of attributes. One is the synthesized attribute and second is the inherited attribute. In the synthesized attributes, the attributes A is called synthesized attributes of X and B1, B2, Bk are the attributes belonging to the production symbol. The value of synthesized attributes at a node is computed from the value of attributes at the children of that node in the past. See the example. Consider the grammar S E N E E plus T E E minus T E T E T multiply F E is T divided by F E F F E F digit N. This is the context free grammar. Now we will write the production rule and its semantic rules. So first rule is S E N. The means of this, print the value of E. Print E dot value. Then E is E1 plus E. Here E dot val equal to E1 dot val plus E dot E is E1 minus E. E dot val is E1 dot val minus E dot val. E T E dot val is E dot val. T is E1 dot T1 multiply F. T dot val is T1 dot val multiply by F dot E. T is E divided by F, that is E dot val T1 dot val divided by f dot val. T f T dot val is f dot val. F is E. F dot val is E dot val. F dot digit f dot val is digit dot length. This n is this can be ignored. Can be ignored. Can be ignored by lexical analyzer. Lexical analyzer. And this is terminating. So here. So this is the synthesized attribute of here. This is the here we want to build the how can synthesize attribute, how to compute the synthesized attribute for this contextually grammar. So here this is the contextually grammar and this, these are the semantic root for this contextually grammar. Next is the how can we build the syntax tree. How can we build the syntax tree from this? We have the expression 5 multiply 6 plus 7. So what is the syntax tree of this statement? Or this expression, we can build the syntax tree by converting this infix to postfix. So here this plus is the root, then this is 7, this is semicolon, here this is multiplier, and this is 5, and this is 6. This is the syntax. This is the syntax tree. Now see what is the parse tree. How can we build the parse tree? Here first is start from E. This is E. Start from this E. First is E plus. Then T is F and this F is digit. This digit is 7. Here in this case E is E multiplied by T and this E is no. This E is T. So first E is T. Then this T is E multiplied F. And this F is digit. So this is 6. This T is F. And F is digit. So that is. So this is the parse. This is the parse tree of this syntax tree. Then next is what is annotated parse. Annotated parse tree. how can we build the annotate parse tree? S start from this S. S is E. This N and this N is this N. Then from this E, E plus T, then T, T multiply F, this T, F, and F is digit dot next value, next value, so that is equal to seven. This T, F is digit dot next value, so that is equal to 6. This T, F, F is digit dot next value, so that is equal to 5. In the annotated parse tree, so this is the parse tree. In the annotated parse tree, every node contains the value of the address. So here, this is digit dot next value. So here f dot where, so that is also is from 7. So this is the synthesized attributes. We get the value from the leaf to the root. So here t dot where, so that is equal to 7. We get the value of f from the leaf, so that is 7. Again, this is 7. From this, this is 5. F dot where, so this is 5. T dot well, so this is equal to 5. F dot well, that is equal to 6. This T dot well, this is the value of 5 multiplied by 6, so that is 13. Here the value of E dot well, so that is equal to 13. Here E dot well equal to 30 plus 7, so this is the 37. In the synthesized attributes, the value is obtained from child to the parents. Here, in every case, the value is obtained from child to the parents. So, this is the synthesized S attribute definition. A computation. Of S attributes definition. Next is the inherited attributes. Next is inherited attributes. Inherited attributes from the definition of this LDD, A equal to F B1 B2 up to BK. See the inherited attributes. The attribute A is called inherited attributes of one of the gamma on the right side of the production. It means alpha, x is alpha, so here this is alpha, and b1, b2 up to bk are belonging to either x or this alpha. The inherited attributes can be computed from the value of attributes of at the sibling and parents of that node. See the example. We have the grammar S if TN TAINT is closed T character T double L is L1 comma ID L is TID. This is the context tree grammar. First write the synthesized rule of this grammar, semantic rules, and first write the semantic rules for this grammar. Here this is the production rule. Now production rule and the semantic rule. Semantic actions. So first is S is T L. So here L dot in is T dot L. Next is T I N T T dot type equal to in T float T dot type is float T dot T character T dot type is character T dot T is double T dot type is double, then L is L1 comma ID. So here L1 dot in is L dot in. Here enter type ID entry comma L dot. Here L is TID, so here enter type ID dot entry L dot. This is the production rule. For this production rule, what are the semantic actions? So these are the semantic actions. Using these semantic actions, now we can build the annotated parse tree. Here the string is int a comma b comma c. The string is a comma b comma c. So start from this. First is s is t. For this t, here for this string we need int. So here this is int. Next, for this L we have the production L comma ID. So L comma C. Here for this L, L comma B, and for this L, this is the annotated parse tree. So here T dot type Here we want to prepare the allocate policy for the inherited attributes. So it gets the value from the from this int. So this int. Next, L dot in is int. So this gets the value from its sibling. Value from sibling. Value obtained from sibling. Then this gets the value from its parents. So here this is int, l in int, like this. So this is the annotated parse for this context free grammar with the inherited attributes. Used to print the final answer of the expressions in the syntax directed definitions, terminal have the synthesized attributes only. Thus, there is no definition of terminals. The synthesized attributes are quite often used in syntax directed definitions. The syntax directed definition that uses only the synthesized attributes is called the S attributes definition. In a parse tree, at each node, the semantic rule is evaluated for annoting the S-attributed definitions. This processing is bottom-up fashion from leaf to the root. Steps are followed to compute S-attribute definitions. Write the syntax directed definitions using the appropriate semantic actions for the corresponding rule of the given grammar. The annotated parse tree is generated and attributes value are computed. The computation is one in bottom up manner. The value obtained at the root node is supposed to be the final output. We discussed these points in these two examples. Next, the inherited attributes. We see in the last example, in the value of inherited attributes at a node in a parse tree is defined using the attribute value at the parent or the sibling. Following steps are to be followed. Construct the syntax directed definition using the semantic actions. So prepare the table with the production rule and their semantic actions. So this is the first step. Then annotate the parse tree. In the last example, first we prepare a table with every production rule and their semantic actions. And in the second step, we build the annotated parse tree with the inherited attributes by processing in top-down fashion. Then, what is the means of the dependency graph? It is clear with the name. It is a directed graph that represents the interdependency between the synthesized and inherited attributes at node in the parse tree. It's called dependency graph. For the rules x is yz, for the semantic action is given by x dot x in f y dot y comma z dot z. then the synthesized attribute in x dot x and x dot x depends upon the value attributes y dot y and z dot z. The dependency among the node is given by the solid arrow. We have represented parsley using the dotted lines. See the example for this dependency graph. Design a dependency graph for the following graph. If E1 plus E2 E1 multiply first the directed regulation syntax LGD for this LGD for this. So this is the production rule. Production rules and the semantic actions. First is E is E1 plus E2. So what is the semantic action of this? E dot val is E1 dot val plus E2 dot. This is E dot E1 multiply. So this is E dot val is E1 dot val multiply by E2 dot val. Now we want to build the dependency graph of this. So first is E dot val. So first we build the syntax tree. Here E1 dot E dot val, here E dot val. Again this is plus, this is E1 dot val multiply E1 dot. Here the value of this E1 dot val, it depends upon the E dot val. Here again it depends the E dot. Here so this solid line, it shows the dependency. So this is called dependency graph. So this is called dependency graph. This is the example for the synthesized attributes. See the example of the inherited attributes. S is T list T int. List Next is the, what is the LGD for this? So this is the production. Production rule, and this is the semantic. Semantic action. As T list, so here the list dot in, so that is the T dot type. T is int, so T dot type is integer, T is float, so T type float, T double, T type double, then list is list one ID. So here list one dot in is list dot in. Enter, enter type, enter type, ID dot entry, comma list dot. Here list ID, so enter type, enter type, ID dot entry, list. Now we can build the its dependency graph. So S see the syntax tree, T dot type, here this is list dot, this is int, this list dot in, comma d, no c, string int a b and c. So here list dot in, so that is comma and z, and this is, so this is the syntax tree of parse tree. So here now we can build the dependency graph. Here this value gets from the from this sibling, so this is one, then this value get from the parent, then parent, like this and this from the sibling. So here from sibling, this is from parents to the child, and here again from sibling. So this is the dependency graph. So this is the dependency graph of this grammar for the inherited attributes. Next is the evaluation order. So if you have the tree, part tree, then how can you evaluate this? So how can evaluation order, how can you evaluate this? The topological shot of the dependency graph decide the evaluation order in a path. This is the path tree. So the topological shot of the dependency graph, it decides the evaluation of order of the path tree. So first we evaluate the value of this. So this is the first evaluation. This is the first. Then the second, it gets the value from this parent list dot in. So this is the integer. So this is the second step. We get the value from this int. Then from the parent it gets the value to the c, so that is the third. Then from parent it gets the value of the children, so l list dot in, so that is int. So that is the fourth step. Next is, from this integer it gets the value for the b, so that is 5. Then 6 int. Next is the 7. It gets the value from 4. So this is the order, this is the evaluation order of this dependency of this part. Next, construction of the part.